Welcome to today's 5-minute Bible study in the Acts of the Apostles. We are at the end part of Acts chapter 15. The Jerusalem Council is over. The momentous decision has been reached. Salvation in Jesus Christ is by faith and faith alone, both for Jews and Gentiles. That has been decided. Paul and Barnabas are back in Antioch in Syria, ministering there. And they decide it's time to begin another missionary venture. Let's begin reading at verse 36 of chapter 15. Now, sometime later, Paul said to Barnabas, "Let us go back and visit the believers in all the towns where we preached the word of the Lord. Let's go see how they are doing." Paul proposes they revisit the churches they established on the first missionary journey. Those, of course, are the churches in Cyprus and the churches in Galatia. That's Antioch of Pisidia, Iconium, Lystra, and Derbe. It's been at least a year, maybe 2 years, since they completed that missionary journey. They, of course, have had contact with those churches through letters, visits. The letter of Galatians, Paul wrote during this time period to those churches they had evangelized. But now he says, let's go visit them again. Let's see them in person. Check on how they're doing, their progress in the Lord. Barnabas agrees, so they begin to plan their next journey. Verse 37, Barnabas wanted to take John, also called Mark, with them. Now, you remember on the first missionary journey, Mark had begun the journey with them. Mark, of course, is the cousin of Barnabas. He had gone with them through Cyprus, but when they reached Galatia, Mark left the company and returned to Jerusalem. But Barnabas wants to take him back on this journey. But Paul did not think it was wise to take him because he had deserted them in Pamphylia and had not continued with them in the work. So Paul said, we really can't depend on Mark. He left us. He abandoned us in the first journey. I don't think we should take him now. They had a sharp disagreement and they parted company. This is really a sad day, is it not? Barnabas and Paul can't agree on whether or not to take Mark. Barnabas is insistent. Paul says, no. So they decide, we'll part company. So Barnabas took Mark and he sailed for Cyprus. Paul chose Silas and he left, commended by the believers to the grace of the Lord. So what they did, they decided to divide their labor. Barnabas and Mark would go to the island of Cyprus. That's natural because, of course, Barnabas is from Cyprus originally. Paul would go, he would travel directly north and then turn west and go to the churches in Galatia. So Barnabas would revisit part of the churches from the first journey. Paul would revisit the other churches. Paul chose Silas as his traveling companion. Now you remember Silas was one of the delegates from the Jerusalem Council to go to Antioch of Syria and authenticate the message and the letter. Now, Paul really likes him and he's got that prophetic gift we saw. So he invites Silas to join him. So now we have two missionary companies, Barnabas and Mark in Cyprus, Paul and Silas revisiting Galatia. They strengthen the churches and encourage them to maintain faithfulness to the Lord. Now after this division of labor, we lose sight of Barnabas. He's not mentioned again in the Acts of the Apostles, and we have no more record of him from this time forward. We know, of course, that he continued faithfully to the Lord. It's just we have no record of his activities. Mark, we will meet again. Mark later comes back into the story. He, of course, later will travel with the Apostle Peter, and he will write the gospel which bears his name. And also, most interestingly enough, many years later, in one of Paul's letters, he mentions that Mark is with him. So even though Paul, at this point, on the second missionary journey, was unwilling to take Mark with him, later, he and Mark do work together, and we find them in companionship once again. And that, of course, is a very positive thing. So we're seeing now the beginning of the second missionary journey. And it begins with a revisiting of the churches of the first journey. The churches in Cyprus, the churches in Galatia. Those churches are strengthened. But more is about to happen. This second journey is going to be momentous for the Apostle Paul and for Silas, who travels with him. But we'll begin to look at what else happens in the journey in our next time together. Hope you have a great day today. Hope you know the blessings of the Lord upon you. And I will see you next time for our 5-minute Bible study in the Acts of the Apostles.